Welcome back to another episode of MotoGP Mac, and today we're going to talk about the qualifying session in the Sachsenring. So, Bagnaia topped qualifying from Quartararo, from Zarco, from Aleix Espargaró, Gigi Antonio, Miller, Luca Marini, Jorge Martin, Vinales, Nakagami, Bezzecchi, Johan Mir, Paul Espargaró, Oliveira, Brad Binder, Alex Marquez, Bastianini, Bradle, Dovizioso, Morbidelli, Remy Gardner, Raul Fernandez, and Darren Binder. Alex Rins didn't take part in qualifying, is not going to take part in the rest of the weekend due to his wrist injury. Qualifying was actually really, really good. In qualifying two, all the top 12 riders were within 8/10 of a second. Now, Bagnaia was on the ball, to be honest. He was the only rider who just got into the 1 minute 19s. Quartararo was like 7/1000 of a second off getting into the 1 minute 19s. So it's definitely going to be a great race tomorrow. Johann Zarco just popped up there. You know, he said he felt good in the morning practice. The track temperature is over 50 degrees today, and it's going to get hotter tomorrow. So track is going to be quite slippy. Aleix Espargaró, Nakagami crashed with about 30 seconds to go, so a lot of people's last laps were actually spoiled because he crashed in turn one. Same impacted Miller. However, Gigi Antonio actually came through qualifying one into qualifying two, and you know, he's doing extremely well. This is the sort of circuit that suits him, where the bike is on its side for a long duration. Miller's lap was spoiled. Marini, you know, he's done quite well. Martin slipped back a small bit. Vinales, again, you know, there was a lot of riders affected by that yellow flag in the last minute or so. Bezzecchi came up from qualifying two, and Johan Mir, again, he was affected, but he didn't seem to have the front end to get there. To be fair with Paul Espargaró, you know, he had a lot of injuries from yesterday, especially when he breathes, his ribs are actually hurting him. So doing a track like this track is probably not the best for him. Solid day from Miguel Oliveira and Brad Binder, even though, you know, they were towards the front of the field last year, 14th and 15th place. Alex Marquez, you know, didn't do anything major. I suppose the surprise of the weekend is Enea Bastianini down in 17th place. Now, when he was talking about what was going on with him, you know, he was referencing this is a GG-style circuit, but GG has been doing really well the last three Grand Prix, especially within the qualifying. He's really outstanding, doing, you know, some great stuff as a rookie. Also, Bastianini's engineer is not there this weekend. He is away with COVID. Solid enough from Stefan Bradl, Dovizioso getting one over Morbidelli. Remy Gardner, whose future actually looks kind of safe with Tech 3. There was an interview with Francesco Guidotti, and he was saying, you know, they're aiming actually to keep Gardner, but not Raul Fernandez. And Darren Binder bringing up the field. You know, look, it was solid, you know, it's not a great track. Darren is not too far behind Morbidelli and Dovizioso. Quartararo, again, being Quartararo, is out gunning every other Yamaha out there. All in all, it was a good session. A bit of an anti-climax with the yellow flag in turn one with a minute to go. There was a couple of them, I think, that would have really upset the order, but look, that's the way it is. Tomorrow's race is really going to be interesting. The track is going to be slippy, it's going to be hot, much hotter than today, I think. You know, it was like nearly 40 degrees air temperature there today, so I think they're planning that it's going to be hotter tomorrow, so definitely going to be interesting. You know, obviously I'm still going to stick with Miller for the race win, and as I said, you know, that's just normally when Ducati sacks someone from the factory team or someone leaving the factory team, they go on to win the next race. But again, I'd love to know who you think is going to win. Leave it in the comments below, and I will see you again tomorrow in our live stream. I just want to take a minute to also thank you for watching my videos and the support that you've shown so far.
if you haven't subscribed already and you would like to subscribe, it would mean an awful lot to me if you did. I'm starting this channel realistically so that we can all enjoy MotoGP together, with the aim of streaming a live video when the GP races are on.